Bill Riles, Tara Mendocino, Ace Point Backgammon. Presenting streaming, live streaming from the U.S. Open in Las Vegas. We're starting off with a round of 32 Masters jackpot match between Jeff Hall from the U.K. and Alfredo Unas from Brazil. Both accomplished players, fairly well-known players. Jeff recently won the Gibraltar tournament in January. And Alfredo had been playing quite a while. Know that 3 or 4 years ago, he won the Super Jackpot in Monte Carlo, defeating Chris Trencher in the final. So quite an accomplished player in his own right. So here we go. Welcome to MCG and Justin Knoll and others watching. As y'all know, I will be monitoring the chat here. So if anybody has questions, comments, suggestions, critiques, or just wants their name mentioned on the air, just let me know. So this is a 15-point match. First game. Both have developed relatively decent structures here. I thought half-decent backgammon had to be Ian, because to my knowledge, he was the only one that knew that Jeff and Alfredo were going to be on the stream. Okay. So this is Wednesday evening. We'll be for the next 4 days having continuous streaming. There's a cube coming from Alfredo with the thought it was a take, and Jeff took it. Picks up another checker. Jeff needs an anchor. Jeff can make an anchor. Then he's there it is. He's in for the long haul here, perhaps. You got to take the four. Okay. 4-3. Now. What can we do now? Just for everyone's information, while he's contemplating this 4-3 on stream two, which is on the Ace Point Backgammon channel on YouTube, YouTube.com/AP Live, that has Stuart Hosen versus Rafael Lopez de Lara from Mexico. Stuart is originally from Dallas. He's living in Vegas now. So Alfredo decides to safety up those two back checkers. He had the option of trying to run, but he would have left others exposed. Alfredo has a 5-2, which doesn't particularly play. He's going to make the four slot, or bring the builder to the five. Dennis Culpepper is in the house. Joe Urso, my man, is in the house. Us baseball fans are all geared up for opening day tomorrow. Joe Urso and others, myself included, opening day tomorrow. Okay, as I was saying, we'll be streaming through Sunday. So we'll have the two live streams. And we're at a new venue. You can see quite a bit of the playing room behind me here in the Westgate Hotel and Casino in Las Vegas. And there's also another room. It's not private. It's open in some fashion to the main playing room, but the streaming room, you can see on the player cam there. There's two streaming tables, and there's some overflow tables that others can play there too. It should be somewhat quieter in that room. Okay. 6 6'5". So it's a nice escaping running number for Alfredo. Okay. Jeff's going to have to probably play two off the eight. He keeps a little pressure on that midpoint. Again, Jeff was teasing me. He didn't want to be streamed. He said he just got off a plane from the UK. But I'm like, hey, man, your fans want to see you. So here we are. Fredo, if he can keep this one guy from getting hit, he ought to be able to bring this home. And he did dodge the bullet. One. Okay. Yeah, this is, and both boards are the same. We have two FM Gammon boards here with the U.S. Open logo on it. Those are FM Gammon is the board sponsor and has generously donated those boards. We're also streaming again, stream ones on the Backgammon Galaxy YouTube channel. So we appreciate their cooperation and letting that be used. Stream two's on the Ace Point YouTube channel, and Tara and I are glad to be able to provide that avenue as well.
Tell them what the address is. Be sure to tell them to like.
Yeah, and be sure, and Tara's standing here over my shoulder reminding me what I haven't said yet, but be sure and hit those like buttons. Always like Mark Olson likes us to promote his channel with the likes, and so obviously please be sure to do that. On stream two, Ian is Rafael Lopez de Lara from Mexico playing Stuart Hosen, who lives in Vegas now, formerly lived in Dallas for a long time. A good player at one time. He played a lot, 20, 30 years ago before he migrated into poker primarily. But at one time, Stuart Hosen was on all the Giants lists and so forth. For those of interest, and I can't divulge anything, but the Giants list results are tabulated and prepared and will be released in the next day or so, according to Carol. But it's done and ready, and everyone awaits the results. Huh? I did tell everyone we're at the Westgate in Las Vegas. Now, this is, for those of you who go back somewhat, this is the original Hilton. If you go back into the, 70s and 80s, I guess, home of Elvis and all of that sort of stuff. So, but it's been, in effect, refurbished. And it's a huge place. It's quite a incredibly busy place that we've observed today. A lot of people here. There's one, it has a whole lot of ballroom space itself, and it's across the street from the Las Vegas Convention Center. So Tara will adjust my camera here, and I'm going to be okay. Joined by the inimitable John O'Hagan. So welcome, John.
Nice to be here. Nice to be here in Las Vegas.
Yeah, a little round of 32 match here. Jeff Hall from the UK, who won the Gibraltar tournament in January.
Wow.
And Alfredo Unis, who you may have some familiarity with. He's been in Monte Carlo a number of times. Beat Chris Trencher in the Super Jackpot.
I remember that.
Three or four years ago.
I remember that.
So, two accomplished players.
All right, and then 24-21 looks right with the last one.
And you played this afternoon, I believe, and won, so you're advancing.
Yes. Okay, let's see here. 5-1 looks like just 13-8 and 11-10.
And brings it into range, but not really anything else to do with
it. Yeah, you have to leave a direct shot anyway. So,
and, you know, the slot on that, the five or seven gives triple shots. So this is about it.
That's right. Yeah.
Joe Urso saying hello to John.
Okay. Hello, Joe. 4-4. So makes the 9 point. And then probably 22-14, maybe, or 6-2 twice. I don't know. I think I'd avoid dumping. I do that. 22-14. 2-0 up to 15. 3-4. Yeah, I just hit. I'd cover rather than hit again. 13-10 looks like the right three to me. How about you, Bill?
Yeah, I mean, it's...
Fewer shots.
It's not an attractive situation. Now, that's a nice roll. He gets his anchor, but he's...
Okay, now the last two, I don't really know what's right.
Go to the eight, maybe?
Go to the eight, or you can make the three. Or you could go to the 11 and start the three-point. So... I don't think it matters much. I'm not sure which of those
kind of an interesting
best. The fact that White has a weak board with a blot in it, maybe should make the
kind
three
of a
point.
Timing contrast too. Alfredo's way behind and Jeff's almost a little ahead of himself.
That's true. I have no real strong preference here. I think any of those three
Matt
plays
says make the 10 point.
Oh, 10 point, I didn't even think of that. That's really solid, actually.
Urso agrees. So
I didn't even think of that. Yeah, that makes perfect sense after having,
that. It's a good one to agree with, Joe. Joe says he agrees with Matt.
Yeah, good job, Matt. I didn't even see that play for some reason.
You know, it's interesting, that board, there's a lot of, good contrast on it, but to my eyes, it's just a little bit confusing with all the blue field and the blue checkers. Hey, John, Jeff Hall and
Alfredo Unis. I think he should make the 10 point again there, right? With that 3-1. Instead, he played 11-8 and 6-5. Yeah. I just don't think he saw it that time. Well, I guess a third chance. There we go. Make a 5 prime. Okay.
Three. Okay. That's a hitter, which probably Jeff could have been without that contemplating.
Yeah.
Maybe putting a little more pressure on
them. Yeah. That's a pretty good shot. And one to go. Yeah. Huh. 6-5 dance. All right. So can consider cubing here. No, I don't think so.
Okay. So on to game 3-2-1. Alfredo.
Yep. Nope, supposed to hit loose there. 13-5.
It leaves Jeff a choice though. Mm-hmm.
5-1. So the question is, die on checker, what's the rule here? They count?
I don't know.
I think they count.
I'm pretty sure they count. Let me check with...
pretty sure they do count.
I'm almost positive, but it's Rory's tournament, and Jeff is going to ask Rory.
I'm almost positive he's an 11-5.
Yes, dice on checkers count.
Yes. Let's see. This is blues roll. No, I'd play 13-8 and 11-10. Just leave a few indirects. The race is close, so. Oh, hold on. Has he played anything? Yeah, he just played the whole thing, 11-5. Yeah, I don't think that's right.
Nah.
Might work.
Jailbreak time.
Hit and cover. And good shot. Good shot. 4-1. Well, now what? Do you play 6-2 or 13? I'd play 13-9. I don't know. You know, he won't like it if blue hits, but it's not the end of the world, and it's a useful builder if it's not hit.
He's from Brazil. Pretty good player.
4-3. Cover, and then either come up or 6-3. Probably come up is in the back is right, and hope for the best. Probably will get hit loose here. But no?
I think it's just a $1,000 jackpot.
Yeah,
$1,000 jackpot. So it's
bad shot. 13-9, 6-4 is kind of forced. Now Jeff gets another whack at. No, no double yet. Now, what do you do? 8-5, maybe? Or 13-10? Well, 13-10 leaves a lot more ways to cover, but does leave extra ways to get hit. So I'm not sure. 6-5, dance.
Okay, take for one.
All right, 117 for blue. $135 for white. So he scoops it up. I don't know. 4-3 makes the one or the two? Probably the one. Well, he makes the two.
Makes the two, leaves the black.
Yeah.
Makes the three.
Cover.
Needs to cover that 4-point.
Yeah, yeah. That's not a covering
that's
number.
That's a little awkward.
Yeah, not a good shot. So, well, let's see. 13-2 or 13-7, 13-8 could run off the anchor. I doubt that's right, but that leaves twos and threes. Bad roll. Roll. Yeah, I probably would hang out of the anchor, but play 13-2, maybe.
Maybe both down.
Well, it does dip.
Both out or both down.
Or both down. There are three plays. They're all not too attractive, but you have to choose something. So, all right. Dupes threes. This could be right.
The dupes, the three, like you said.
And 20 numbers miss, so. That worked.
One game rollout was pretty good.
Yeah.
Okay. So now he's got to cover that and safety the.
I think.
Well, he could hit loose.
Yeah, he didn't have any direct covers, though, so the hit loose is kind of questionable. I don't think so. I think I would have played 15-13 now. No threes.
Threes. So 12s. Now you got to bring it down.
Yeah. Yeah, it's probably too many blots to play 13-7 there. 5-4 dance. Kenny cover, 9 or a 12. All right, now 13-7, 10-5, I think. That way, sixes and fours, which if he gets hit back, will not be covering entering numbers, so he can hit back with those numbers that include that enter with the other numbers of four or a six. And he danced.
Okay, this does not look promising for Mr. Unith.
So let's see. He's got 14, 20, 25, 25 outfield pips. So it's probably, I don't know, maybe he's a slight favorite to lose a gammon here. Something like that, I would guess.
Definitely in jeopardy of it.
Yeah.
Of course, then Jeff gets hot on the back and could swing with one roll.
Yeah.
Okay, how greedy does he get, John?
Yeah, I think
he probably
greedy.
Doesn't need it.
Huh?
Do you?
I think I would have. So that's only a few extra blotting numbers, you know. And every extra checker you get off, you know, increases your gammon chances.
Did you want to?
Don't worry, I'm not really using money.
Okay.
4-4. Well, these guys are rolling big numbers. Big doubles.
Sixes and fours. Huh?
Yeah.
So he could get out of this. Now, Jeff needs a set. Hmm?
Yeah, that's correct. Okay.
Any set. Probably feels he's due after those big sets from Alfredo.
No.
Doesn't get it.
So 3-2 in favor of Jeff.
Yeah, it's that's true. Tara's reminding us Jeff's known as for extremely loud shirts and so forth. So he's kind of out of character tonight.
Yeah, different style tonight. Just kind of standard.
Jeff Hall's from the UK. Now he is. Is he still president of the UKB Jeff? At the at the end of last year, he was president of the UKB Jeff. I'm not sure if that's still the case or not. Perhaps somebody can fill us in.
Alfredo makes the good attacking play with 4-4 there. Gets hit back. And 5-3, enter and hit. Yeah, looks right. Fewer blots that way. That looks
good. And he's got the three-point board, a much stronger board.
Ooh,
aces, that's a
shot.
Nice shake.
Three men to the five, looks right. Yeah. Okay. Double threes. Makes the 10 and 24-21 is my play. That looks right. Mm. 6-5.
Okay.
6-4. Probably everything, 21 out.
Probably 21 out. Or maybe, yeah.
Looks right.
You
can't nothing, hit.
For all his distribution, nothing.
Yeah.
Nothing pointed or anything.
Yeah, sometimes the dice just don't cooperate with your plans, you know. 6-3, okay, make the 2-point, I think, hitting. Pretty clear.
Yeah, that's a...
And he's on the roof, enters, and he's got a 5 to play. Yeah, 11-6 looks fine. Mm-hmm. 3-2. All right. Now, I don't know what's right. 13-8. 13-10. 24-22. 13-10. 8-6. I don't know. I'd have to think about this one. I'm not sure what's right.
I was going to look real quick. I should remember this, but I don't remember this. Who did Jeff Hall beat in Gibraltar final?
Four, three for one.
I
didn't like that last two, though. I'm just saying.
34.
Oh. 134. Dora, I'm not saying anything.
I should have remembered this. In Gibraltar, Jeff beat Mark Farron from San Antonio final.
Okay.
In fact, I think Mark, I'm not mistaken, Mark was the undefeated bracket winner, and Jeff beat him twice.
Ah, okay.
Ian or somebody can correct me, but for some reason I'm thinking that was the case. But,
okay.
Mr. Stubbe is in the house.
Hey, Rich.
So,
2-1.
They're starting to roll in many more of the events.
It's like
start tomorrow.
Bar 22, right? It's blue. I'm sorry. I was thinking it was white's roll. Okay, 6-4, just run out.
I don't know why they, because it's confusing to me a little bit and to everybody else. They're not playing with the cube on the board.
That is kind of weird. I don't see a cube either.
It's over behind the scorecard. There's no reason not to have it on the in one of the trays.
Yeah, plenty of room.
R is gonna ask them to do so, and that'll help us all out.
Yes. So now that you mentioned, I do see the cube back there. Yeah, now it's where it should be.
Yeah.
All right. 5-1 in and 9-4.
Tough five.
Probably has to do that. He doesn't want to offer up another plot against the stronger board.
Yeah, I think that's clear. So can blue double this? He thinks he can. And it's a take. Alfredo scoops it up. I think it is a pretty clear take with that 22-point anchor. Not that many gammon losses here for white, so it looks like a take. 64, I guess you make the 18.
Yeah. This one, it's a beautiful board, but it's kind of tough on my eyes. It's just, I don't know, the blues are a little overwhelming. But.
So here he decides to keep the 22-point anchor. He's probably afraid that if he makes the 18, the checker might get attacked. He might get closed out and get gammoned by keeping the anchor. It lowers his gammon chances. But
it's there, yeah.
I still think probably making the 18 was probably right. 6-2, you can get gammoned anyway. There. Okay, 3-5, he's in. Makes the 9.
Oh, look at the 9.
Thank.
Okay, that's totally safe.
It's reasonable, but with our play, clearing, making a 9, you're clearing the mid. Now he's going to clear it now, and he's got to leave an indirect shot or two anyway. So he either plays 13-5 or he plays 13-7, 13-11. Three shots this way, 3-1 and 1-1. So 6-1.
Okay.
All right. So Jeff has a clear advantage here. 6-5.
That's unfortunate. He would have liked to have attacked that guy, I think, perhaps.
Yeah, but,
didn't get the opportunity.
Yeah, that's right. So
what was been wrong with 13, 8, 11, and 5? So leaving that shot out there.
Yeah, yeah. He could have done the other play too, yeah. Okay, now do you clear the 8 point and leave a couple indirect shots? I think so. Yeah, I think
you got to clean it sooner or later, and he's probably going to be a little better, and better boarded for the
next
roll.
Yeah, if you get hit now, then unless white rolls double fours, he cannot also cover. So and now, yeah, and here he didn't get hit.
Wait a minute,
he
should be able to. Doesn't that hit that 6-1?
No,
it's 8 away.
8 away.
Oh, okay.
Red to red.
So 6-1. Yeah, that could be right. You know, by bringing a checker in directly to the six, you reduce your gamma losses. Question is
well,
that
you
right?
You got more potential to make the 3 and 5 as well.
Later. Yeah, that's right. So 6-5, I guess just bear that guy off. Yeah. And you have a zero position, as Mitchie calls it. No plotting numbers. 6-3, yeah.
Man,
41, 4 off, and then something with the 1, either 6-5-4 or 2-1. I don't know. 5-4 looks.
5-4 looks fine. Looks the prettiest.
Yeah, yeah.
I like 5-4.
Yeah.
Really, all Alfredo.
Because you roll double threes, you don't leave it on. Double threes leaves a shot unless you have 3 on each point.
Okay, 4-1. All right. So do you start clearing or do you?
I take it off the slot.
Off?
Yeah.
Yeah. Could well be right.
And Alfredo's just going to.
He's just trying to save the G.
Just save the G.
Yeah.
If he gets super lucky, he'll worry about that when the opportunity presents itself.
That's true. Yeah. 4-2, bring that one around. Yay. Well, it's totally stripped now. So if blue rolls a 6-3 next time, he won't like it.
Got to run. Right. It's not as bad, but
Alfredo's out. Yeah, no, just a single shot.
Almost.
All right.
Do you break from the 4 or the 5 here?
Yeah, from the 4, because then there's no shot.
Yeah, yeah, that's right.
Mm-hmm. Really his only option.
Was he thinking of voluntarily leaving a shot to take a checker off? Boy, I don't think I'd do that.
No, that's
that looks too much of a gamble, I think.
Ian wants to know, who did John win against earlier today? It was some unknown.
I forget his last name, from San Diego, David, I don't remember his last name.
Mm-hmm. No, he did not play Ray, although Ray won, I think, his match.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, Matt says play safe. I think everyone's pretty much in agreement to play safe here.
Seems like it, yeah. You know, there's not that many. In order to win a gammon here, okay, if you make that big play, say 5-3 to off hitting, then, you know, white has to dance, and then you have to still not get hit after that. And
there's some.
Get all your checkers born off.
You know, you get a hit and dance, and he rolls a set of aces or something.
It's not like white's got a crunched board. I mean, white doesn't currently have a strong board, but it's reasonable.
Has some potential.
Yeah.
He's worried about the gap, I think. Maybe 6-3-1 wouldn't have been too bad.
13-5. Okay.
That'll work.
Yeah.
Okay. Does
oh,
that smarts.
He's off the G.
Okay. Off the G. He beat two in a row.
5-2.
Okay. And just out of curiosity, and you changed your nickname here to Half Decent Backgammon. Was that based on any of your recent performances or what? Half Decent?
Oh, I didn't know anyone had said that, but yeah.
He's assumed the name Half Decent Backgammon. Ian has.
And who wrote that?
Ian. He's using the nickname Half Decent Backgammon.
Okay.
I know some people have blitzed with that double six.
Maybe that's to what is that?
Okay, this could be a cube here. After that early 6-6, now he's made the 5-point. He's got a 4-shot and a 6 and a 1 to cover. Not going to lose many gammons. Going to win, a bit more than in the starting position. I think it's a double, and I guess I'd take. Not 100% sure on the take, so it's got to be a double.
He lets drops. That go.
Okay. Could be right. I don't know. But definitely a double.
Probably a very small take. Right.
Yeah, Matt says pass must be bad, particularly trailing too.
So what? Oh, Matt thought it was a take.
Matt thought it was a take.
Okay, 3-1, 5-point, yay, 6-4, run out. Jeff rolls 6-6, 3 down, and then
out.
Probably out. Yeah, usually that's the right play. There's a big gain when the opponent doesn't roll a 6 or 1, and when they do hit, it's usually not that big a deal. So, all right. Who's a quick pip counter here? What do we have here? Is there enough here to?
Well, that's 12 times 6.5 is 78 and 39. That's 117. What do we have?
133, 133 to what?
117, so
16. 16 is using the trice formula. It's a pass for money, and I doubt there's enough to change it at the score, so I would also pass. Yeah.
Okay. That was a really simple cluster counting position.
that's a method I don't use, but I know a lot of players do. So, all right, run out. 7-2 up to 15. 42, 4-point. 6-3. Hey, I leave the fly shots. Yeah, do that.
Ian wants to know your thoughts on the Kleinman count for getting a good percentage in match play race counts.
Yes, very good.
You like that?
I do. Yeah. I do. The nice thing about the Kleinman count is that it'll give you a approximate winning chance for any pip count differential. So, if it's something like 100 to 120, all you know is that for money, it's a big pass. Well, sometimes it might be a take, depending on the score. That's where Kleinman can come in handy.
Well, that was a nice cleanup roll.
1-1, yeah. 2-3, and I'd come up with the other one, too. 24-21. That looks a little weak. But maybe I'm wrong. That's what I would do. 6-6. Oh,
a lot of
4 freight. Down. Yeah. Okay. Good shot.
Now he's going to be faced with a little bit of a dilemma on the next roll, potentially, though.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. This is where, this roll would have mattered.
Huh?
All right, makes the 5 point probably. And then maybe 13-9.
13-11 and 7-5.
I'd probably leave. I don't know if it's right or not. I'd probably play 13-9, 7-5 twice.
Matt's with me, 13-9-2.
Okay.
Now.
Good bait.
This is kind of an interesting little position here, way, trailing 7-2.
Well, and also with your and Matt's play, 6-6, you know, high numbers become really a problem for Alfredo's side, right? 6-6.
Yeah.
5-5. So you guys could be, and plus now you have four builders aiming at your 5 point, or I'm sorry, three builders. One's threes and fours. I don't know. Okay. You could be right.
Matt likes it and says fastest way to make a five prime.
Yeah. Could be right.
What match are you watching?
Oh, it gets out of sync with the stream. This is actually what everyone's seeing.
Doubles, not many gammons, so I take 4 or 5. Good shot.
A lot of good market loser there. Losing sequence.
5-3. Okay.
Must have known something.
No. All right, 11-6, and then either 8-5 or 24-20. I'd go 8-5. Yeah. 6-4 around to the 5 point.
Well,
he 6-5 makes a point. So, yeah,
he needs the 4 point, doesn't get it, but yeah, can make the deuce.
Yeah.
He doesn't expose anything.
Bad shot.
That's a lot of freight.
Yeah. You gotta kind of do it though, yeah. And then the last one, probably 7-2.
Yeah.
So the thing about White's position here is that with Blue having an anchor on the 22, most important point to make is the one directly in front of that. And now White probably will not be able to make.
Yeah, he's only got what?
And just a few, a few numbers plus a few doubles. And like here, he can make it, but by leaving a direct shot, or
but he's two blots on the far side.
Two blots, it might well be right. You know, the alternative is
make the 9-9-4-6-4.
I think that's right as well, but not 100% sure. Yeah, 2 and a 5. Yeah.
He's still it's forced play, more or less.
Now, can he get out of there? Yes.
Okay, so
4-1.
Nice number.
But see how not having the 4 point, these problems just become worse and worse as you go.
Brandon Macklin Magnet. Brandon Macklin is it.
In living color.
In living color.
I might have gone ahead and made the 4 point last time.
Well, money, volunteer?
Yeah, the two blocks.
Hagen doesn't like
3-5. Yeah, I think playing safe was right with that 4-1. But, I mean, you know, look at this problem now. White's got 6 buried checkers behind the anchor. Yeah.
It could get bad in a hurry. Okay, 3-1.
Yeah.
For either,
yeah. 6-3.
He's gone.
Yeah. 4-1. Yep. 13-4.
You got to stay for the shot.
Yelled at me for not making the four.
Stay for the potential shot.
Thirteen to four looks right?
Yeah, I would.
It looks like you're pretty far down in
the
race.
Pretty far down the race to run. I know that.
Yeah.
And, you know, Alfredo may roll a 6-4 or something.
Yeah, there's quite a few blooding numbers. So,
got to be that. Four, two.
Shot time.
Can you get this more in sync with the fresh that or something?
Okay, I'll teach you how to do it.
It didn't.
Needs to be.
Now it is.
Yeah, and that is.
Okay. You just need to make sure that when you tap it that this is live. That means you're live.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you'll see like a number of minutes back.
Okay. Thank you.
All right. So, standard bear off here with white having a solid edge here.
That's a pretty ugly roll.
Yeah.
4-3.
Big time. 5-1. Two up.
Got it. Maybe 11.
I think it was, yeah. 6-2.
Shouldn't
the comeback.
Nearly the walk in the park that Alfredo Matovic.
That's right.
Anticipated.
Whoa,
looky here. Whoa.
9-2.
Oh my God.
That hurts.
Two.
Sweeping the floor with that one.
Man. That's why we love the game.
Yeah. In a long match like this, something I notice is that when the trailer's away number is more than twice the leader's away number, it's a sign for the trailer to get pretty aggressive with the cube. So here it's 6 away, 13 away, 13 over 6, more than 2-1. So you can double earlier, take later.
Well, you know, it's always kind of an obvious case, but I'd never heard it in that specific relationship, I guess.
Yeah. Yeah, it seems to be a pretty good rule of thumb. All right, it makes the 18. That's a good shot. So now, really, Jeff has the kind of game that you like playing from with a big lead in the match, you know. Got the advanced anchor on the 18, and he's, you know, not much gammon danger. So it's a good position to play from.
No, why would you not go to the 21?
They hid the cube again. Jesus.
Oh, they did, yeah.
Tara may be listening on the headset in there. If so, she can straighten it out.
Why didn't I go 24-21 there instead of dropping up?
4-2. Yeah, I'd make the 4-point. I guess you could make the blocking 9-point, but 4-point. Yeah, right. Yeah, Brandon Macklin just pointed out that making a 4-point is the advantage of unstacking the big stack on the 6, whereas if you make a 9-point, you're not doing that. And you're leaving a shot, although it's not too scary with white having two blots in her board. 6-2 hits. I doubt it. I just cover the 5 and the 4, I guess.
Yeah. I'll return. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. 4-3. All right. So do you hit? And.
Yeah. 18, 14, 18, 15. You're moving both up.
Yeah, it's probably right. Not that many return shots. Twos and threes are duplicated to enter and to hit. And the alternative isn't that attractive.
What else would you do?
11 to 8, 6 to 2, you know. That's kind of 18, yeah, hitting and then going to the 11 only leaves one blot, but leaves
good
more return shots, so... I think so, yeah. And he does.
This thing is way behind. It's on. It's not on the Wi-Fi. It's on the...
No, it's still whatever.
2-5. Up to the 18 is clear.
Keeps getting behind. Way behind, but whatever.
I mean, if you'll change it again or not.
Safe.
Hey,
yeah. 11, 8, and 15, 14. Yeah. All right. Makes the 18. And then. Either eight,
you have to be someone careful.
Oh, no, no, no. Got to make the 18 there, right? Now with the 6, I'm not sure. Are you? Yeah.
I think you have to be someone doubling from blue scoring.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, with blue being advanced as he is on the 13 and 14, he's got to make the 18.
Yeah.
Not free.
So, I mean, the 4 is clear. The 6 is not 100% clear. You could, yeah, this is just the right play, I don't think. Okay, whoa. Look at this. Talk about a big swing, huh?
Yeah. Wow.
With the correct play, you got an 18-point holding game. Yeah. With this play, you have nothing. Double pass. Two to 10.
Five away, 13.
Yeah. 3-2. Look at the clock. They reset the clock to 30 minutes each.
Uh-huh. Hang on.
Yeah.
Hang on.
Go do it.
Yeah.
You may need to take this with me for a second.
Yeah.
Okay. And then okay. So she can reset the clock to what it was at the end of
Tara's
last year.
Tara's got to review the review the film.
Yeah, they double hit. So I do think Alfredo's play with opening 3-2 is right at the score, 2 down rather than the normal play. But it's close.
They're taking a break.
Yeah. I'll reset it, and they'll go to the down the hall.
Betting man that bet on the man and red, white, blue flag.
You think?
Yeah, his flag matches the board. You know what I mean?
That's right. It does.
The Union really Jack does. Matches the U.S. Open board. Huh?
That's right. Does and he's got a slight edge in the score as well.
Oh, now here we get a dual image here. Tara shows us real quick what's going on stream too.
Raphael and Stu Hosen.
Stu Hosen and Raphael Lopez de Lara.
Where's he been all these years?
Yeah.
He currently lives in Vegas, I believe.
He's moved to Vegas. He's, I guess he got out, he got into poker for a number of years. I mean, back in what, early 90s, in the 80s?
I don't know.
He was a really,
oh,
very highly regarded backgammon player.
That's very true.
I mean, he was on the Giants list back in the day.
Oh, yeah, sure.
And,
the colors of Her Majesty's Secret Service.
Okay, for y'all's information, while we're on the break here, of course, we're watching on youtube.com/backgammon galaxy and stream two, which is the Stuart Hose and Rafael Lopez de Lara match, is on youtube.com/AP Live, which is the Ace Point YouTube channel.
You want to take my place? You sure? Because I'm
sure. I'm sure. You look good. You look scholarly.
Well, I'll talk through the end of this match. In the background?
Yeah. People know my name. They don't know my face.
I'll help Bill here too a little bit.
Well, that's like
is my microphone on. I can't even tell if this is even things even on.
It's on.
Hello, hello.
Okay, yeah.
It's on.
I had no idea.
Okay. Okay, so 5-2 in the other match, up to 15, and a quick double and pass. Okay.
Okay. Thank you. You got that straightened out somehow. Okay.
32.
My iPad, where I'm reading the chat here, showing the stream, but it was somehow or another getting out of sync, and it was really disconcerting trying to to read it.
Yeah.
But this is cool. Well, since we're on break, you asked Rory, is there anything after this round tonight? I can inform the watchers.
Rafael, he's been coming to this Vegas tournament for ages.
He has. I mean, I can, as long as I've been here,
yeah, which likewise,
is probably, sadly, close to 20 years that I've been coming here. Rafael's always here.
Yeah.
Ooh,
good shot. Makes the two and the one, obviously, right? Put two checkers on the roof. I mean, that's clear, right? Unless I'm not seeing something.
No, that's correct. Absolutely. The 7-2 and 6-1.
So, always something to be said for two in the air, you know?
Yeah.
Particularly with no blocks in your home board.
There's definitely a blitz playing here.
Yeah, okay. It took him a minute, but he found it. Okay. Okay. Too good.
Dan's way too good.
Way too good. Yeah.
Keep playing. Okay, Rory says there may be what? Oh, Tara says there may be a match after this, but it'll be a surprise, and she's not going to spoil it for us. So hang in. Only on stream one.
Now, the main reason that it's better to hit it with a 4-13-9 is because there's an extra builder for the inner board.
Oh.
Twos, fours, and fives to hit. All right. So
double three.
Still makes the 5 point. And then.
I'm with the.
You know, 24, 21, 8, 5, or 11 to 5 or I like 24-18.
I like 24-21-85.
Yeah, this is reasonable too.
Because now you're picking, you're putting a checker on a point that's already made.
You're actually, Mr. Brain, you're on stream one, although we've gone to split screen while stream, while Jeff and Alfredo are on break. So as soon as they resume, we'll go back to just that one screen, Jeff Hall, Alfredo Unis, to the Rafael Lopez de Lara and Stuart Hosen are on stream two. Oh,
looks like they're coming back.
They're coming back.
Okay. Yeah, it looks like
this is some of Tara's latest technology of being able to put both streams up on one time. Wow.
So if Rafael is able to close out four checkers, he even has a reasonable backgammon chance. So.
Okay, so here we go. We'll never know.
Yes.
Okay, there we are. Okay, so where were we? We were
6-1.
One move blue. Into the
yes.
into the game before
we right. 5-2. I like that play. I don't know if it's right or not, but that's what I would do. 2-1, I think. Make the 7. I mean the 5. Sixes are somewhat duped, so it looks right. Ooh, look at that! Boom! So much for duplication. Make covers Boom. The 5 and makes the 7. Or you could make the 18 and bring a spare to the 5. I would go offense at this score.
We have to make the 7, I think.
Yeah, I think so. Double pass.
Yeah, now it's just send it.
Three back on the 24 doesn't look promising.
He's actually thinking about it.
Well, it's good that he's thinking about it. I mean, you know, but, you know, the other thing about this score is that if Jeff does take the cube and turns the game around, Jeff will have to be really careful about finding the right time to redouble. He won't be able to redouble like in a, at a normal score. So therefore, holding the cube won't do him as much good. So I think all that adds up to a pass, pretty clear.
And, yeah.
21, there you should slot your 5 is a little better, I think, at this score, trailing 10 to 3. You want to build up a strong board prime. Gives you more gammons when it works and you know, more gammon losses when it doesn't, but gammons, extra gammons gained are more valuable to the trailer than to the leader. So, not a big mistake, but a small mistake, I think. 42, hit and come up.
Step up.
Yeah.
All right, 20 and 10. Yep. Okay, Alfredo's got a, he's in attack mode here.
Yeah.
I just hit it.
I think you have to
13 to 5. Yeah.
13 to 5.
Absolutely. He needs to try to seize every opportunity that he's got trailing, yeah. as big as he's trailing.
All right, hits back.
Okay. That makes the point. He wants it.
Yeah, just make
get the make five. The five huh?
Sure.
And now get ready to send probably, it again.
Probably, yeah. Okay, now what do you do with the last 3? Do you play 6-3 twice and 13-10, or do you play 8-5 three times?
I think you make 6-3 and then 13-10 is the last one.
You step up?
Or you step up and make the 3. That's another play.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah, this looks pretty reasonable. Now, he can think about doubling here, and I'm
surprised he didn't.
I would have definitely thought about it, and... try to decide if I have enough market losers. You know, you certainly have some. You know. So. But I thought that would he would You know, he's got a ton of time remaining on his clock. And so he could have, you know, really gotten some use thinking about that for a minute or so. He's got 25 minutes, you know.
So, I'm kind of more leaning on 7-2, 6-1, 2-8.
I didn't really.
You have a huge stack on this 6 point that you're not even using.
Certainly double pass now.
Man, geez. You think it might be too good here?
I doubt it. I mean, but sometimes I make that mistake. I think a lot of us humans do. Because we've all seen games turn around, you know.
Yeah.
Whereas XG doesn't have those feelings, you know. XG just says, well, we win X amount of gammons and we lose Y amount of single games, so it's too good. I don't know. 10-4.
Okay.
3-1, 5 point.
Dimitri has entered the room.
3-1. 5-2, yeah. Looks right. Okay. I sometimes hit too often. I'd be tempted to play 6-3, 24, 23 here. But it might be better to go 21 and 5 or 13.
I was saying 21 and 5, but I don't know.
These are problems I should know, but I really don't.
Okay, it's
all right. 4-1 looks again, right.
He's got to be aggressive, so.
And he rolls 5-3.
Okay, so. Alfredo. At least putting a cartridge in the chamber. He hasn't decided to pull the trigger yet, but
he's moving too quick, and I think he should be spending little time on whether or not he should be
okay
doubling.
Now I think this is going
this is definitely now is it a take? It might well be a take because you're likely to anchor somewhere.
It really doesn't have much of a board right now.
That's not a particularly attractive roll.
Maybe you're supposed to be aggressive though.
I would almost hit
on the four,
stick four.
Come around to the 9 point. Yeah, I think I would have too.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, 4-2. Well, you probably want the anchor. And then with the two.
Just slot it.
Well, either that or 13-11. You wouldn't really mind a fourth checker back here. You know? So I think I would have played 13-11, but. All right, so all you can really do is do that and leave a double shot. Well, okay, you can do that. I admit, you can do that. Pretty sure that's not the right play. Fewer shots, but.
He probably doesn't like that he's got fives and sixes out and covering with twos and fours.
Yeah, I know, but. Well, it would have hit and covered. Play I thought was right. So, not nearly as good.
Slot to seven and make.
So, yeah, make 13, the four. 7, 8, 4. Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, you don't want to come out.
No, it's
check
a double.
22 is in no danger. So,
just go to the
13 to 7.
Go to the 7.
Not sure what he's thinking of. Not sure what the alternative would be. 8-4, 8-2, it doesn't look right. Just 13-7. Come on.
He definitely wants to come out to the 15 or the 16. He's got two blots in there, so.
Okay. Well, I have to leave another shot. Okay. So.
Make the ace.
Yeah, make the ace. Make the ace with the with the one, and then with the five, either play 13-8 or 15-10. I'm not sure.
Yeah, I kind of like that one. You know, if he wants to break the anchor to hit it,
double the breeze. Wow.
But he does.
And then 13-7
covers the bar, right?
13-7 or cover the 15?
No, cover the 7.
I think.
He's ahead in the race now.
Find me the schedule.
Yeah, make the prime strong.
Yeah.
Double fours.
Okay. That's smart.
How strong does the leader have to be to redouble? Probably not worth it even thinking about.
Much stronger than this. Could be a clear take now.
Well, now he's got
a big mistake to double. 6-3 out. Now you got a hit and contain. So it's definitely no redouble here.
That is John Veeder Dimitri on my right over here, Mr. Veeder himself.
I say Vitor.
Vitor.
You gotta pronounce the O.
Okay.
Yeah, the Vitor Cup is at my house every year. September, usually the mid-September. This year they've got the Vegas tournament in September, so it's kind of competing. A lot of players may want to decide to play in the larger one, but usually get 20 people at my house. Very nice, comfortable atmosphere. Swiss format. Yeah, 9 points all the way through.
And that's been going on 40-something years?
Well, it started in 1962, 1981 by my father, and then I started up again from 2000 to current.
Wow. That's the longest-running tournament ever, anywhere. 6-5, safe. Okay, so now Alfredo was able to escape that lone checker that got, that got hit earlier. But
it's kind of interesting. He's way behind, but he's in a pretty good position as well.
So 7-2, even though it only leaves you with one spare six, I'm pretty sure that's the right play, though. 6-1 doesn't look right. 3-2 either makes the 3 or 13-8. Probably
hope Jeff ends up having a crack up here before he can get out.
I think he's got to not save a 6 here. Play 7-2, 6-3, and hope for the best. But he does it this way.
I prefer John's play. Yeah. That's kind of awkward.
The 8-2. Okay. Yeah. His play does save a 6, but is it a good 6? No. Yeah. Pretty ugly anyway. So I don't know. Double ducks. Okay. He'd be better off with our play. He wouldn't have wasted a checker down to the ace point.
Okay. So now it's pretty close now. Well, in fact, Jeff's ahead.
So, let's see. Take point for the trailer score.
They are both here, Ian, by the way. Dana and Jeb are both here. Jeb's on staff. Dana's playing. He beat Jonas Seawald in the Masters, the 4 o'clock start, or what, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock start.
I was watching a 3-hour-long match.
Yeah, they played for 3 hours. It was long, long, hard-fought match. You got it, John?
Thinking about 22-43. It's
going to be what? We want to keep that contact on the mid. The blue's way ahead in the race, so we want to try and stay up there.
About 9, 7.2. I'd say take point, taking cubic into account is 14.8.
Wow. That's pretty interesting.
You can look it up on
very actually interesting
on Recube.
Yeah. Okay.
I'm sure Matt or Joe or Ian or Dimitri will have comment for us on that.
And I didn't even count what the pip count was.
I didn't either, but you know, and Jeff's fairly well ahead, but he's, you know, one big set, and we're looking at the potential at least for an 8 cube going the other way. But so it's not,
yeah. So the thing about five away is that when you do win 4 points, it gets you to Crawford.
Yeah.
It's a nice game.
So what did the viewers say regarding 4 cubes? Was it a proper double?
Well, they haven't said. Dimitri said he didn't see it. He was too busy reading the chat. That's a hazard we all.
You know, I didn't even count the pips. After I came up with the take point, they had already gone redouble take. So I don't know what it was. But I think take point is, like I say, 14.8 is what I came up with. So,
well, Alfredo's.
Oh, there that is. Okay.
Well,
14 to 4.
This is a DMP type okay. score now.
So now, just while we're setting up for this next game here, real quickly. 1:30 p.m. local tomorrow, the championship and intermediate divisions begin. And then set your clocks at 7:30 p.m. local tomorrow night. We have a lecture by backgammon giant Ray Fogerland titled Getting in the Zone, and that will be streamed live. So 7:30 p.m. tomorrow. So
part, and then during dinner break we'll take the stream down and we'll bring it back up starting with Ray's.
Yeah, we'll start streaming at 1:30. Matches start tomorrow and we'll stream until the dinner break, which starts at 5:30. We'll take the streams down and then at 7:30 we'll resume streaming with Ray's lecture. That'd be nice, Daphne. Ray knows all about getting in. I have no idea what perhaps follows this. Tara's teasing us that...
What's going to follow is assuming stream one is, or stream two is still.
Okay, so we'll move to stream two until that completes, and then whatever the. We'll make an executive decision, she says, on some surprise potential.
Okay. I almost like making the 9 point here. 13-9.
This is White. Well, looks like he already played two of them, John. He's only had two more. So you're saying
he could have made the nine.
He could have made the nine, but
I see. I was trying to figure out what Bill and Tara were hinting about here. So. All right, 6-2. Just play around to the 6 points. Yeah. I've won. Well, 18-13 looks right, and then you have a one.
Yeah, I mean, 18-13 looks like a lock, and then
8-7 or 13-12. So one's better if they run out; the other one's better if they don't. And I guess I'm not sure. Probably 8-7, but could easily be wrong.
Does anybody know if Ryan Rubello is here at this tournament? I don't know if he made this.
I don't think
he's not here.
I haven't seen him and I haven't heard that he's going to be here.
Well, you got a hit. That was a good play. And 4-3. Okay. And 8-5.
Well, he lives on for a moment.
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
And it just depends on what doubles have. It's only streaming one.
Okay. Tara's telling me after this match is over and stream two is over, the doubles starts tonight, and we may stream a doubles match, which some kind of special doubles match. But it's actually a real pairing for the doubles event.
Okay.
But we don't want to... We can only stream one match at a time if it's a doubles match, because it would be
general comment here about Alfredo's play. You know, he's got here, it's 14-4. This might be the last game of the match. He's got 24 minutes plus remaining. He really should have spent some of that time on some of his earlier checker and cube decisions. You know, he started with 30 minutes. He's not even use 6 minutes, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, there's something to be said for just following your instinct, but I mean, there are some times when you just have to calculate things, and you can't do that immediately. So, 5 point.
Joe went back and put that in, by the way. That was a redoubled take to 4.
Well, this isn't very good.
Well, what were the winning chances for the underdog?
What was the winning chances for the underdog, Joe?
Six, three. Oh, that's not very comfortable at all.
Jeff is in great shape to win the first round here.
83%.
Yeah. So 17 for the underdog. And I said take points 14.8. Okay. That's a take.
Now, what is he trying to do with his 5-3 exactly?
Well, he's just got a gin position, basically. He just doesn't want any.
He doesn't want anything, any doublets to... To make and crack.
Right.
So you want to split the checkers so there's not any doublets that might make you crack.
And I don't think he needs to hit the second checker, maybe. Yeah, it's a small deal.
It's just always a small chance he can anchor. And
Yeah, it's going to be a crashed anchor game anyway. So might not be much for Jeff to worry about, but... If you close out one checker in this sort of a position, your winning chances are, you know, 97% or something like that. And a crashed ace point game wins more than that. So, you know, therefore probably, but of course, when you hit a second checker, they don't always anchor. So sometimes your 97% goes even higher. But
I know in this type of instance, sometimes people have been known to get rid of the bar point, leaving one out there. It was a trap play in a way, with that kind of a board.
Well, a trap play, you wouldn't want to do it this score because Jeff doesn't get any extra bonus from winning a gammon. So, all right. So now against a totally crashed ace point game, maybe 3 or 4% is all he has anyway.
Natural trap anyway.
Shot time. All he has to do is hit and win.
Hit and then Jeff roll aces and deuces for 10 rolls or something.
Oh, he gets another shot. Six, two.
This has been a match. Alfredo has had something akin to what we call buzzard luck in Texas. You know?
Yeah.
You can't kill anything and you can't find anything dead. nothing's gone his way.
Yeah, it happens. Yeah.
We've all been there.
Yeah.
So it appears Jeff Hall will be playing in the second round tomorrow.
That's correct.
So I'm going to get up and stretch.
So she's going to switch over to stream two here.
Somebody else wants to help you with the commentary there.
Here we are. Nice tight match here. 9-8 Stuart Hosen.